That's a great question. I guess my easiest answer is I don't know, but I'll tell you one example of or a story that I've worked on that I found really interesting, because I think it is in some ways the future of capitalism, or perhaps the future of, you know, or what happens after capitalism in some ways, and that's Dubai. And I think when I go to Dubai, a city in the United Arab Emirates, it's probably the economic capital, although the political capital is in Abu Dhabi. But Dubai's always struck me as, in some ways it's a cliche, but I think in some ways it's also an accurate way to describe what's happening in that city. It's the first globalized city. You know, when I report there, when I work there and try to do stories on what's happening in Dubai, I realize that this is in some ways, you know, capitalism gone to its logical conclusion. And what we're dealing with is in some ways is a sphere of activity, is a realm of activity in which there are no politics. There's almost utter disenfranchisement. You know, the restrictions on the flow of capital have almost been completely removed, and we're dealing with a society that is in some ways nameless and faceless. It has lost its identity beyond the service of that capital. I think that's fascinating. I think it's something to me. I think in the way it is a window on the future, albeit a dystopic future. But even in that sense, and this is something that struck me, I tried to do a story on it, and the story didn't turn out as well as I wanted it to, but even that sense of the fullest, you know, maturation of a globalized city, there still is almost like a human instinct to create politics, to organize around some issues that, you know, that we would define as political. I mean, what we're seeing in Dubai, that even in this kind of like, you know, this rampant sense of this rampant capitalist environment, we're still seeing organizing going around workers' rights, around labor issues, and sometimes very striking organizing. It's happening in the face of a lot of repression and very authoritarian reactions. So I think that's very interesting. We are seeing those kind of issues. We're seeing issues of some gender, you know, gender issues that are coming up, anti-trafficking that some NGOs are trying to tackle, and we're also seeing issues of identity. And I think this idea of a nameless and faceless society in which identity again becomes an issue, I think is very interesting and very relevant. I think Dubai, in a couple of instances, that's why I find it so interesting. It is, in some ways, the most globalized city. It's also a way to understand what shape politics might take in a globalized environment like that.